Intelligent, controllable, and reportable seating layouts are a breeze within Vectorworks Spotlight. New enhancements to the Seating Section command provide you with additional layout methods, multiple seat numbering, and graphical controls that are all easily set and modified from the Object Info palette. Begin by creating a 2D object to use as the boundary for the Seating Section. Then, go to Event Design, Create Seating Section. Pick a focus point for the seats to indicate the desired direction where the seating will face. The Seating Section settings will now appear. Under the Arrangement pane, we'll first go over the different alignment types. Shift Rows will shift the symbol selected for the seating section so that only instances fully fit into the assigned shape will be used. The overall alignment for the fill will come from the primary and secondary fill directions. In this example, we have the primary fill set to go from left to right, so it's aligning with the slanted left side. Align Rows will make it so all of the seating symbols align between the different rows. This will apply to both sides of the seating section. Offset Rows will make it so each alternating row has a 50% offset. This option produces good sight lines, but is also an undesirable sawtooth line on the row ends. Distribute Rows will set the spacing between the symbols automatically to fill the provided shape. This layout is a useful compromise with a highly efficient seat fitting, but is difficult to set up because the spaces between the seats in each row vary. The final option of the placement settings are for rise. We can set this to have an overall rise from the start to the end of the seating section or a specific rise per row. The final setting in the Arrangement pane is the location where we can select our symbol or symbols. As of Vectorworks 2018, we can now select multiple symbols to use in the seating section. The symbols selected will repeat. We can add multiple symbols into the seating section, and we can add the same symbol back to back if you wanted them to repeat right after one another. In the top left of the dialog, we can also switch off the standard configuration and go over to curved if we're looking for more of a theater setting layout. Under the section information pane, we can give a specific name to the section and number the seats and rows and configure the numbering to our liking. Under the limits pane, we can go through and set limitations to our seating layout. As an example, let's say we're only seating 50 people for this event. We can set the total seats option for 50, and any seats over the 50 limit will display as locus points in the preview to the right. We can use multiple settings here, so if we also want to limit it to 9 seats per row, it will automatically update to reflect this change. The angle pane will allow us to set an angle for the seats. There's also a new setting for adjusting boundary with angle, which will automatically shift the base shape used for the seating section to match the new angle that we set. The Classes pane includes settings for classing each part of the seating section individually, which is useful if there are times we don't want to see the numbering, or if there are times we want to turn off the chair or table geometry completely. Many of the options found in the Seating Sections dialog can also be found directly in the Object Info palette.